How do stock exchanges make money? Well, there are typically four sources from which a stock exchange makes money, and these are: first of all is the listing fees, second one is market data, third is technology services, and the last one is transaction costs. And let me tell you one by one all of these in detail. So first of all is listing fees. And previously I told you companies list their shares on a stock exchange. And of course they do, I'm not wrong on that part, but they pay for it. They pay for listing their shares. I mean, when there is a big marketplace and you are getting some benefit of it, then first you have to pay a price for that. Companies have to pay two types of listing fees. One is the fees when listing their company on stock exchange for the very first time, and it is a one-time fee. And second one is a recurring one, that is, they have to pay fees annually. Both the fees paid by the companies depends on exchange to exchange. For the first time listing fee, a company may have to pay up to $250,000 to be listed on NYSE, while on NASDAQ the fee may range from $50,000 to $75,000. Annual charges on NYSE can start from $45,000 and can be as high as $500,000. While on NASDAQ, same can start from $42,000 to $75,000 per stock per year. Fees are usually charged on a number of stocks, that is, the more you issue, the more you pay. While the NYSE charges more fees, NASDAQ is basically known for charging less. And that's why you're gonna see a lot of small companies listed on NASDAQ. And that was all about listing fees. Now let me just move on to market data. So have you ever watched a stock price on some financial website like Yahoo or Google Finance? And have you ever seen that ticker tape running at the bottom of the CNBC or Bloomberg while the anchor is telling you to buy some stock? Well, these real-time data you see on ticker tape are provided by stock exchanges to these websites or channels. So next time you see ticker tape, remember NYSE is always making money off that. And it's not the only data provided by the stock exchanges. There are some other types of data, such as historical data and summary data. Now, historical data is used for analyzing companies. It is mostly used by quants. Quants are the people usually who trade in stock market based on algorithms. Tape readers also use this historical data. Tape readers, if you don't know, are those who trade in the stock market by reading price quotes and then sees a pattern after reading a bunch of price quotes. If you want detail, then you can just search on Google, although nowadays very few people are considered to be tape readers. And finally, summary data is used for usually auditing purposes, because when you make money in stock market, then you have to pay taxes on all these money, and you can't pay exact taxes without knowing the exact data, and that data is again provided by stock exchanges. So stock exchanges make a lot of money from market data. Third is technology services. So as the world is tech savvy now and everybody has got their smartphones in their pockets, so stock exchanges like NYSE and NASDAQ see this opportunity and provide products such as trading software, applications for banks and other institutions. Usually these softwares are provided by stock exchanges to big clients like trading firms, asset management companies, banks, etc., for basically faster execution of the trades and real-time data. So this source is not very good for exchanges, as a fraction of revenues only come from here, but still it is considered to be one of the income sources of exchanges. Last one is transaction costs, and this is a big one because the major chunk of revenues comes from this source. Transaction cost is the single most important and biggest source of revenue for stock exchanges, contributing about 70 to 80% of the revenues. Every time anyone buys or sells any stock listed on stock exchange, they make money off it. Whether it is banks, hedge funds, big business houses, or retail investors. They make huge money off it. And millions of shares are traded on stock exchange every day. So this seems to be like the evergreen source of income for stock exchanges. So these were some main sources of income for stock exchanges.